Blacks die of homicide at 13 times the rate of whites when they're between the ages of 10 and 43, according to the CDC. That's a problem, and that's why the cops are in minority neighborhoods. Hi, my name is Heather McDonald. I'm a fellow at the Manhattan Institute and the author of The Diversity Delusion and The War on Cops.
In this whole debate, people talking on social media, it's very easy to get very emotional. And you provide a very, I guess, level-headed approach to all this. So with the data and the facts and the statistics and things that you've compiled, do you think that the police are racist?
No, I don't. And I think there is room for emotion in this discussion. And I have emotion for the victims of crime. And that's who the police have emotion for as well. So when I hear about three-year-old children being regularly killed in Chicago, that is something that should be part of the discourse as well. They're not being killed by the cops. They're being killed by criminals. As far as data, it's hard to move away from the individual awfulness of something like George Floyd, something that has appalled the country, rightly so, and every police officer. But it is the exception, not the rule, Will. The police kill about 1,000 people a year, about a quarter of those blacks. Blacks make up a far greater percentage of violent crime suspects in the country, sadly. Black victims make up a disproportionate share of homicide and shooting victims in the country. That is a civil rights problem that we should be concerned about. But the number of police shootings a year of blacks is completely proportionate, in fact, under proportionate to the rate of violent crime. For example, blacks are about 15% of the count of the population in the 75 largest counties. They commit, according to victims and witnesses, this is not some racist police officer making these numbers up out of his head. They commit about 60% of all homicides and robberies. And again, their victims overwhelmingly are blacks. Blacks die of homicide at 13 times the rate of whites when they're between the ages of 10 and 43, according to the CDC. That's a problem, and that's why the cops are in minority neighborhoods.
Yeah, so black on black crime is a much bigger issue than over policing. I mean, we went and talked on the beach to some black kids about policing and stuff, and I said, how many unarmed black men were killed by police last year? They said 1,500, 2,000. Right. And then I say, well, it was actually only 9.
Yeah.
And it blew their mind.
Right.
So when you hear data like this, that only 9 unarmed black men are killed, why do you think that people are still so strong on defunding the police?
Well, I think there's been a long vendetta against the police. I think the left likes to think of itself as anti-law enforcement. So this is not some instinct of the moment. This is something that has been building for decades. The university is dedicated to the proposition that America is a white supremacist country, and the police are the very instrumentality of that white supremacy. It is a narrative that is impervious to facts. I wish that the people who are calling for defunding the police would attend the police community meetings that I have in the South Bronx, in Central Harlem, in Central Brooklyn, in the South Side of Chicago, to hear those good people, the thousands of law-abiding residents of high-crime neighborhoods who beg for more police presence. I have never heard anybody say, we want fewer cops. Instead, what they say is, why do you arrest the drug dealers and they're back on the corner the next day? Why don't you do something about the kids hanging out by the hundreds fighting? Because those good law-abiding residents know that out of those groups of youths emerge the drive-by shootings that just this week took another three-year-old's life in Chicago. And on Father's Day took another three-year-old's life in Chicago. The drive-by shooters, these idiots, were aiming at the gangbangers, at his father, who was a gangbanger, driving him along, possibly using the child as a shield. That's what the police are speculating. The people that understand the reality of urban crime are the ones who want more police, not these protesters that don't have a clue what it is like to live in a community where the norm of fatherhood has broken down.
We've seen places where they've defunded the police now, and what's happened. We also saw in Ferguson, the police were too scared to go into a lot of areas, and the crime totally shot up. Are we seeing kind of a Ferguson 2.0 now?
what we're seeing now is so much faster and so much deeper and so much more worrisome than we saw during the first iteration of the Black Lives Matter movement, which was 2015 and 2016. That wasn't even about defunding. It was mostly just a narrative about an epidemic of racially biased fatal police shootings of Black men, which was untrue. Again, every police shooting of an innocent civilian is something that is horrifying and deplorable, and it's something that the police train constantly to try to avoid. But what happened in 2015 and 2016, because of the first iteration of the Black Lives Matter narrative, the phony narrative, was another 2,000 Black males were killed compared to what the numbers were in 2014. What we're seeing now in just the last month easily exceeds what the first Ferguson effect was. You're at levels of homicide that haven't been seen. We had a June in New York that was the bloodiest in quarter century. You have homicide rates doubling in places like Minneapolis and Milwaukee. The gangbangers, having lived through the riots, the 2 weeks of riots where the police were overmatched and told to stand down, have gotten a very clear message. Anything goes. And we're going to see a loss of Black lives that will make the first Ferguson effect look like a walk in the park.
So what is the solution for this, or what would you recommend?
The solution is to start telling the truth about why police are in minority communities to save Black lives. I don't know of any government agency more dedicated to the proposition that Black lives matter than the police. And it's to start listening to those elderly residents of high crime neighborhoods, to the hardworking business owners who are terrified of robbers, the women who are terrified to go to the store, the children who are now going to have to start sleeping in the bathtub again like they did in New York City before Mayor Rudolph Giuliani and Police Commissioner William Bratton actually started lowering crime. You had children sleeping in bathtubs. Given the rate at which kids have been shot in their homes by stray bullets coming through and sometimes being aimed at those homes, we're going to move back to those periods. And you know what? If we think we want economic revitalization in high poverty neighborhoods, you do not do that by cutting the police. You do not get economic revitalization with high crime. You first lower crime and then you hope for economic and jobs coming back. You make people feel safe, and then businesses come back.
Well, it's very important that people speak up, and we talk about that at PragerU all the time. I want to thank you so much for joining us today. You guys heard it here. Speak up. Share this video with your friends to get the information out there. Comment your thoughts down below. We're going to see you guys in the next one. Thank you for watching. What's up, guys? Thank you so much for watching this video. PragerU is a 501c3 organization. Help us keep our videos free by making a tax-deductible donation today. I'd really appreciate your support.